I have a cold. I am going to give you ways to get over a breakup. This might be a little more lenient towards girls breaking up with guys or being broken up by a guy or a girl. I don't know. I've never been a guy dating a girl, breaking up with a girl, or being broken up by a girl. So, tip number one. Thank you. That's right. Let it all out. Cry. Yell at me. Get mad. Get angry. Do this all in a harmless way. You know, you don't want to hurt yourself or hurt other people because that's just not cool. Learn that from Barney. You're going to be mad. You're going to be sad. You're going to be, you know, hurting. You're going to feel bitter. It's good to just acknowledge those feelings, experience them, and then let them go. Because if you keep them bottled up, you're going to end up exploding. Pew, pew, boo, boo. You definitely want to make sure that you don't drag on this whole crying emotion roller coaster thing for a long time. Because it can become really unhealthy. So you probably should be like this your first week. Second week. And third week. Dr. Phil, eat your heart out. Tip number two. Move on. And trying to move on is the hardest thing in the world. I know, believe me. I know maybe there's some hope burning up in you that there might be another chance with him or her, but you have to remember why you guys broke up in the first place. And once you recall all the bad moments that you guys had that led up to that breakup, you're gonna start feeling like this, you made the right decision. Or unless in some case that he comes back to you realizing that he or she did wrong, you know, or maybe you realize that, then make sure that it'll really work this time and just be honest and open with them and have, you know, great communication, because if you don't have that, then it's basically nothing at all. And you really have to ask yourself if it's even worth the emotion, if it's worth crying over, if it's worth, you know, spending time to try to save the relationship. But when you try to do that, you don't want to be the only one trying, because when the other person is just not into it and you're just, you know, chugging on, trying to save whatever you have, holding on to that rope, climbing up on that hill, and, you know, you get rejected and they push you down and they cut that rope and you're left with basically nothing, and your pride is gone, your dignity is gone. You do it all for love, which is great, but you have to ask yourself, is this worth the trek? And lastly, get distracted. So when it's like weeks past, you know, since you guys broke up and everything, you realize that you have a lot of spare time in your hands. Spare time that was usually being taken up by, you know, he or she. So what are you gonna do with that spare time? Gonna get distracted. That's what you're gonna do. You're not even gonna think about him or her at all because you'll be distracted. Reconnect with your friends again, because you probably lost some of them due to the fact that you were so wrapped up in love. You know, hang out with them again. Do what you used to do. Go get ice cream. Go paint a painting if you're talented and if you like that stuff. Go color a coloring book or get involved in school. Do better in school, maybe. do everything that you used to do before you guys got together. You're gonna be so busy that you don't have time to think about him or her. Thank God. And on a last note, you can totally get through this. People get through these things every day. And I know it sucks, and I know it hurts, and I know you just want to curl up into a little ball and just imagine yourself down the road alone with 30 cats living in your parents' basement. No, that's not going to happen. You will get through this, and it's good to think positively, and you have to let go and let yourself be happy and let yourself move on, because when one door closes, I don't know, some people say a window opens, but I like to think bigger, and I like to think another door opens that's even bigger. I believe in you. You are a strong, independent, self-sufficient woman or man who deserves to be happy and deserves to be loved. Just because this relationship didn't work out doesn't mean that you're doomed for the rest of your life. So this is a learning experience for you. You didn't know that, did you? Added a little, you know, learning. It's like a lesson, like I taught you something based off of my own experience. Experiences. It's like all of this pushes my eyes